Hello and welcome to Arcanum. Today I'm going to tell you about all the way to make money in the game, despite not exactly being early in the game or needing money. So I know this video may not be the best. But yeah, you can start from Shrouded Hills, but never mind. This guy have quest for you, he pay you like 50 or 100, but it doesn't matter. You can sell your story to him in exchange for 800. First he offer 500, but you refuse this offer and he offer 800. 800 gold early, not too shabby for just talking. However, this have repercussion. You will not be able to talk your way out of assassin encounter. However, encounters are kind of optional, but not quite. There's a quest you can do to this guy for 100, but you cannot read the note he gave you. Otherwise, he will try to his friend will try to kill you. So it's not exactly best quest. For Madame Lily, you can for yourself to Mr. Franklin for 300 if you are girl, or give present for other woman if you are boy. Both cases are great. If you are girl, you can immediately steal from Mr. Franklin this ring, and I use this ring to the end of the game, so I would say it's pretty good offer. I mean, one of better reasons to play as a female. Also, a female can refuse girls from Madame Lily as reward, and as results, get please excuse me, it's not, I'm not trying to waste time on purpose, it just take time. Here, there is normally chest, right here. You can destroy it. And inside you will find 2000 gold or 4000 gold. Max is 4000 gold. I never had perfect 4000, but I was close. This ogre guard will not react to your destruction of the chest. You can basically talk to him, but he's bodyguard of Willowsbury. If you loot this place, there is decent number of finds. It's nothing great, but will keep you. However, there is one more trick, and it requires you to have purple magic to unlock cantrip. And you need spell, you cannot have scroll. Okay, so trick is that you go here. If you go here at day, you need to steal key from one of these guys. And then you will have access to door. If you go here at night, you stand here, you crouch and you shoot this door with bow, and then you stand there, you crouch and you unlock cantrip this chest. This chest will provide you with endless supply of cash. And these items are unidentified because you need to wake up this magic shop clerk. And once he open inventory for you, all these items will be identified. Without identification, you can only use potions and scrolls. Resurrect scroll, dominant will scroll, conjure spirit scroll. Oh, actually, we need conjure spirit to invisibility. I had no idea it exists. Holy shit! So yes, I would say opening this chest is worth it. By the way, I didn't fucking stage it or reset days or did anything to make it real. I had look at this. We can identify items in his shop. What a fucking nice coincidence! I was in the market for identified fading. If you will, you can also do this. Offer trading. Fuck. Okay, she doesn't have cash, but Also, I don't have expert barter to scam her. And that is it for Tarant. For Tarant. This is not end. So, in Shrouded Hills, you need magic aptitude. Magic aptitude of something like... Yes, 54. And first, you basically steal key from Ristese. He have key in his pocket. And contrary to all NPCs, Ristese key open his chest. Here in his chest is usually 1000 per day. If you're extremely impatient, you can just rest the day 5 times and get 5000 or something. I don't like it, but it's an option. With better unlock cantrip, you can cast all the spells to unlock these things. This require you to have 50 magic aptitude and be good with permanently open doors and interiors and cast it from here. You need solid distance to cover it and you need to permanently open doors trick to make it fully real. But yeah, you can unlock this barrel and this chest and also this herbalist chest. These are all tricks I know. They together they provide you with such solid boost of cash and arrows that you should never complain. And also bullets if you use bullets for some reasons. And thanks for watching.